What do you think will happen to the college football landscape when Nick Saban retires from middle of nowhere, Tennessee? Well, in Tennessee, which is the state that I happen to reside in, that will happen. If you're watching the video, there's just confetti all over the place. I really think a state holiday would be declared. He has waged war on this state for the better part of 2 decades. I guess we're going on 16 years now. Listen, Louisiana Monroe has a better record against Saban than Tennessee does. That's a stat. That's a real life stat. He is, however long he's been there, 15 years, 16 years, he is that number and O against Tennessee. So in Tennessee, it would be a holiday. All across the SEC, I think they would not respond the way that they say they would respond. You know what I mean? Like, I think a lot of folks around college football, they wake up every morning and they check their phone. Dang, man, he didn't retire today. Yeah, I know most of you not named Alabama want him gone. Like, Bama fans want him to stay forever and everyone else wants him gone. But that's only because he's really, really good. But you also, most of you at least, have this different side of you that's there, whether you know it or not, that supremely respects what he's done. So I want you to imagine for a second the day where this actually happens. You would have an excitement because now everyone proportionally is going to have a better shot at coming out of under this carpet that's been over us where we can barely breathe for like the last decade and a half. But then you would realize something else. You would realize, hold up, the greatest of all time just retired. And I got to see him. I lived through it. See, I remember, I think I've told this story a bunch, but I remember when I was a little kid, I was not born until after Paul Bear Bryant had passed away. So when I was a little kid, we always heard stories about Bear Bryant. Like if you're a Notre Dame fan, you probably heard stories about Parsegian or you heard stories about Newt Rockne from a couple of generations prior. But you didn't get to see him. You know, if you're a younger person, you didn't get to see them. Well, now everyone who is living got to see him. So if he retires tomorrow, yeah, you may be excited because the University of Arkansas has a better shot at winning. But man, I think there's another side of me, and I think a lot of our audience and just college football fans in general, that'll sit back for a second and go, whoa, like I know I wanted this to happen. And it's not like I'm wishing he changed his mind, but let me just appreciate for a second what just ended. Like the greatest run that we'll ever see in this sport just ended. If we see a better one than that, I'll just be happy to come on the show, whatever it looks like 30 years from now, and say, yeah, I was wrong. He got outdone. I don't think he'll ever be outdone. So whatever his run ends up being, I think it's going to be the greatest of all time. So I think the reaction is going to be that of immense pouring out of respect for Nick Saban from the college football public. And I think that will probably overwhelm some people compared to what you expect the reaction to be. I mean, I think it will completely and totally get wall-to-wall coverage. I think it'll get mainstream news coverage. So I think whether you turn on SportsCenter or the NBC Nightly News, you will see that Nick Saban is retired. There aren't many figures like that in sports, and there are especially not many figures like that in college football. Now, I hope that this is a long ways down the road, but whenever it happens, as it pertains to on-the-field matters, let me tell you what else I think it'll do. I think it'll immediately inject more competitive balance into the landscape of the sport. And I think a segment that we did last week on Late Kick Live will prove to be true. You'll realize all of a sudden, no team is dominating. There's some really good teams. There's still a tier one, but it'll totally be redefined. Like there was a tier one before Saban got to Bama, but that was during a stretch where we had 10 different championship teams in a 12-year period. So we had different teams contending. We had different teams capable of winning. We'll have that again when he leaves. And what you'll look around and realize is we made all this commotion. We demanded all this change in the sport and unfortunately, in my opinion, got a lot of it. And all we needed was him to retire this whole time. Turns out college football really did just have a Nick Saban problem in air quotes for those listening on podcast. I think it will be a landmark day in the history of the sport if and when he retires. And then the great unknown is what's he going to do? We're recording this in a week where it was just announced that Tom Brady, when he retires, will step into the number one lead analyst role for Fox NFL in the broadcast booth for about 20 to 25 million a year, by the way. So good for Tom. It really calms my nerves that he won't be hurting for money. But also, what's Nick Saban going to do? There has long been rumor in our world that there's an offer. There are multiple offers waiting for him. That's just kind of not even speculated. It's just kind of known in our world that there are offers. I would imagine, and I'm not confirming this one. This is speculation on my part. I would imagine there's a pretty popular Saturday morning college football show that has a chair waiting for him and probably has a check with a blank in the dollar amount that he can just fill in anytime he wants to. So I think just as much as it's interesting what it would do to the sport, I think it's interesting what he would do, because he can really choose to do whatever he wants to, including perhaps co-hosting an episode or two of Late Kick. We'll see. Well, you know how our policy is with guests, so we'll see.